I'm a 16-year-old who just graduated from high school as a straight-A student and recently celebrated my 16th birthday. I have lived between my divorced parents' homes for most of my life. My mother, a talented 35-year-old Martin Brassategui, 12 stars at a top Russian restaurant in our city, has been raising me on her own for the past year and 10 months. My father, who used to manage a family cement factory, was diagnosed with brain cancer, leading me to live full-time with my mother. Despite our strained relationship due to her often rigid and contentious nature, I managed to find peace in the situation given my father's health issues. My mother remarried 8 months ago to William, a man 27 years old, after a secretive year-long relationship that she only revealed when he proposed. Their significant age difference and the timing of my father's diagnosis made her hesitant to share the news sooner. I never warmed up to William. His excessively sweet demeanor felt disingenuous and unsettling. Unfortunately, my instincts about William were confirmed just 5 months into their marriage when I caught him stealing. The situation escalated, and when I exposed him, my mother chose to side with him and kick me out. She later pleaded with me to help save her marriage. But overwhelmed and feeling betrayed, I decided to move 5,010 miles away to live with my father. Now, as my mother threatens to disown me, I find myself needing to share my story and navigate this new chapter of my life, far from her but closer to my father, who has always been my anchor. My stepdad was a college tennis coach, so he usually got home before my mom. This meant we spent a lot of afternoons alone together, but he hardly ever spoke to me during these times. However, as soon as my mom arrived, he would suddenly become overly friendly, acting like we were close. It was obvious to anyone that his behavior was just an act. One afternoon, while I was getting a snack from the kitchen, I heard a noise from my mom's bedroom. I knew she kept a secret locker under her bed, where she stored her wedding jewelry from her marriage to my dad and other valuable items, including some emergency cash. She didn't trust banks much and preferred having her valuables nearby. The keys to this locker were supposed to be with her at all times, and I held the only spare set. Peeking in, I caught William red-handed, pulling out a bundle of cash from the locker. I froze in shock. When he saw me, his irritation briefly flickered before he smiled and casually draped his arm around my shoulders, escorting me to the living room. He concocted a story about my mom needing the money urgently for a work-related emergency and reassured me that everything was fine. Later that evening, when I tried to tell my mom about the incident, she preemptively shut me down. She didn't even let me start and snapped that she didn't want to hear any complaints about William. She seemed to expect that I was going to criticize her choice in him or urge her to reconcile with my dad, which was never my intention. Despite my efforts to explain the situation, she refused to listen and even threatened to ground me if I spoke against William. This response left me both frustrated and concerned about her unwillingness to see the truth. After the incident with William, I felt completely alienated from my mother, who seemed more enchanted by his superficial charm than aware of his true character. If she chose to live in denial, then I wasn't going to try to convince her otherwise, especially after she had dismissed my concerns so rudely. I stopped bringing up the subject and hoped that one day she would see William for what he really was. However, she never did, and over time, our relationship grew increasingly strained. Then, about a week ago, my mother decided it was time for a serious conversation. It was just the two of us at home. William was out with his friends. I braced myself for bad news, perhaps about my dad. But that wasn't it. Instead, after beating around the bush, my mother abruptly told me that I needed to move out. William had expressed feeling uncomfortable and unsafe around me, which was absurd. It became clear to me that William was trying to remove any threat to his position, fearing I might reveal his true nature to my mother. Her request was shocking. To think that she would choose William's baseless insecurities over her own daughter was heartbreaking. I realized then that any attempt to expose William's deceit was futile. My mother had already chosen her side. I was so frustrated and done with the whole situation that I agreed to leave without arguing. As I packed my bags, my anger was palpable. Though part of me wanted to confront William directly, a better plan formed in my mind. I remembered the spare keys to the secret locker. Quietly, I snuck into my mom's room and took them from her purse, leaving a note that if she wanted her keys back, she should ask William about them. This was my way of ensuring he wouldn't escape accountability. With my belongings packed, I said goodbye to my mother. She seemed genuinely surprised that I was actually leaving that very day. Despite her initial shock, she recovered quickly and hugged me goodbye without any visible emotion. It was clear that she was not troubled by the turn of events. Leaving the house, I boarded a bus to my dad's place, which was nearly 5,010 miles away in the suburbs. I had mostly lived with my mom because of my dad's ongoing medical treatments and his need to be close to his hospital. He stayed with his brother, and that's where I was headed now, away from the turmoil and closer to a hopefully more stable environment. My dad, who lived with my uncle, had always taken good care of him. Whenever I visited, which was almost every week, I made sure to keep our conversations light and cheerful. I wanted to shield him from any unnecessary stress about my situation. Despite missing him terribly, I had never divulged any details about William or my mom's behavior to him. When he would ask about life at home, I'd reassure him that everything was fine, glossing over the truth. However, after moving in with him, I could no longer maintain this facade. It was crucial for him to understand what had been happening. So I laid everything out for him, including the events that led me to leave my mom's house. When I described how I had left a note to expose William's deceit, my dad became visibly angry, his ears turned bright red, a sight I'd never witnessed before. I was worried this might affect his health, but he managed to calm himself down. To ease his concerns, I explained my actions further, including how I had taken the keys and left a note, which I hoped would force my mom to confront William. This seemed to reassure him somewhat, and he praised my cunning. Both he and my uncle assured me that they were more than ready to look after me. They had only agreed to let me stay with my mom full-time because they thought it would be easier for me, but now they were eager to have me back. I felt much more at home with them, undisturbed by my mother's decision to send me away. The first day at my dad's passed without any word from my mom. However, the next day she sent a video of William crying and apologizing, pleading for me to return home. He admitted his wrongdoing and expressed regret for having driven me away. Along with the video, my mom texted, claiming it proved William's remorse and his guilt for what he had done, including forcing her to expel me from the house. Although it was satisfying to see William in distress, my mom's subsequent messages were frustrating. She said she would only forgive William if I returned, making the situation about her ability to forgive him rather than addressing the wrongs done to me. It was exasperating that she was even making this a choice for me to consider. It should have been her decision to end the marriage and apologize for not believing me, not just waiting for me to fix things. The choices she offered, returning to a home where I felt invisible or treated like a burden, were unacceptable. No one should have to choose from such dismal options, and it was clear that staying with my dad was the better choice for me. Considering the depth of the situation with my mom and William, it was becoming increasingly clear that she was, in some ways, worse than him. Despite being my mother, she had chosen to prioritize another man over me, which felt like a betrayal beyond repair. It wasn't just William who owed me an apology, my mom had a lot to answer for as well. Instead of showing remorse, it seemed like she was turning the entire ordeal into a twisted game, expecting me to dictate the future of her marriage. After I told her I wouldn't return home, she sent me another video, this time of a somber yet still visibly upset William. He tried to explain that he loved my mom and was pleading for one last chance to prove himself. His voice was shaky, on the brink of tears, almost as if he was about to beg on his knees. Despite his emotional display, I remained unconvinced and affirmed that my decision was final. My mother's response to this was to accuse me of being overly harsh. Here were two adults, supposedly putting their happiness and marriage on the line to win back my approval. But their actions felt manipulative rather than genuine, and I felt no obligation to mend the distance growing between us. Choosing to ignore her subsequent messages, I distanced myself further. Over the next 3 days, she bombarded me with texts and video messages, both she and William apologizing repeatedly. She even went as far as to threaten divorce to prove her seriousness, sharing texts showing she had contacted a lawyer. William's latest video showed him appealing to my sympathy, claiming he couldn't bear to lose someone like my mom. Despite knowing my stance might be affecting their marriage, the entire scenario struck me as profoundly unhealthy. My mother was not only manipulating William, but also placing me in an incredibly unfair position. She was essentially making me the scapegoat for any potential end to her marriage, framing it as if their happiness hinged on my acceptance. but it wasn't my place to decide the fate of their relationship. It was manipulative and wrong to make me feel responsible for their marital problems. Both of them were adults, and it was bizarre how William allowed himself to be diminished in this way, possibly influenced by my mother's wealth. This whole ordeal was dehumanizing, and it felt wrong to even engage with it further. I couldn't bring myself to dignify their actions with a response, knowing deep down that I should not be the one to make decisions about their marriage. It wasn't just a matter of choosing not to be involved, it was about recognizing the toxicity of the situation and refusing to perpetuate it. William is caught in a cycle, just letting my mom control the situation daily. I've kept this from my dad to spare him the stress. I know if he found out, he'd step in, leading to a dramatic confrontation that could be too much for him right now. It's a tough spot to be in, feeling guilty for not wanting to force my mom into deciding whether to leave her dishonest husband. After reflecting and reading everyone's comments on my previous post, I realized maybe I should share my burdens with my dad. I've always tried to handle things on my own, partly because I don't want to bother him, especially now that he's dealing with cancer. It's made me reluctant to add to his worries, but the consensus was clear. I shouldn't go through this alone. Taking that advice, I finally told my dad everything about my mom and her manipulative behavior. He immediately called her out on it. She tried to dismiss him, saying it was none of his business, but he wasn't having it. He even threatened to seek full custody, making it clear that her actions were unacceptable. She protested, but it was obvious her concern was more about appearances than genuine care for me. If she truly cared, she would have been a better mother from the start. After hanging up, my dad reassured me that I should never hesitate to come to him with any problem, echoing what many commenters had said. He stressed that being my father, my well-being was his priority, and his illness wouldn't change that. It was a profound moment for me, realizing despite his illness, he was still the strong protector I remembered. Breaking down in tears, I was overwhelmed by a sense of safety and love I hadn't felt in a long time. My dad's words reminded me that no sickness would ever stop him from being there for me. It was a powerful reminder of the unconditional support I had forgotten in the chaos with my mom and William. I'm incredibly grateful for his steadfast presence, reminding me that no matter what, I'm loved and protected. My dad has officially filed for full custody, and my mom won't have any visitation rights. It doesn't make a huge difference since I'm nearly an adult, but my dad emphasized that he no longer trusts my mom due to the influence William has had on her. Recently, my mom sent me a message accusing me of disappointing her by involving my dad, especially knowing his health condition. She called me selfish and manipulative and claimed she was glad she hadn't left William based on my accusations. She said my efforts to drive a wedge between them had failed and that they were stronger than ever. She even said she was content to give up custody, claiming I didn't deserve to be her daughter. Her words were harsh, but I'm past letting them hurt me. Her defensive reaction only shows that she knows she's failed in her role as a mother. My maternal grandparents have even threatened to disown her, but she's indifferent, so consumed by her relationship with William. It's shocking, really. I've always known we had our differences, but her current behavior is beyond rational understanding. Even my grandparents' attempts to reason with her have failed. Fortunately, my dad has allowed them to remain in contact with me, recognizing that they've done nothing wrong. Reflecting on everything, I wish my mom could have learned from her parents how to maintain a healthy relationship post-divorce. They managed to raise her well despite their own separation. Now in her 35s, my mom's choices are her own, and she can no longer blame her parents for her actions. Unfortunately, she's failed not just as a wife and mother, but also as a daughter. Today was a mix of emotions. My mom formally terminated her parental rights over me, making me legally free from her. I was there with my dad for the signing, and seeing her again, likely for the last time in a while, was surreal. She didn't even acknowledge me, which was painful yet somehow a relief. I'm sad but also relieved it's complicated. William wasn't there, unsurprisingly. He's irrelevant to me now. Afterward, to lift my spirits, my dad and uncle took me out for dinner, which helped cheer me up. We also received some hopeful news. My dad's health is improving, and it looks like he might beat his cancer. I cherish every moment with him and hope for more good times ahead. I'm relying on those good vibes and prayers from everyone.